The Shia, they first appeared during the time of Ali himself. And the origins of this group go back to a person by the name of Abdullah ibn Saba. He was a Jew of Yemeni origins. Ibn Saba claimed that Ali radiallahu anh was God incarnate, God on earth. He claimed Ali was divine. When Ali radiallahu anh heard of this group, he warned them and advised them and commanded them to repent, but they did not listen to him. So he commanded that they be burnt to death. And this punishment is recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari, that he commanded a group of heretics to be burnt to death. The heretics referred to, as Ibn Hajar says, are these Saba'ites. However, he was not able to capture Abdullah ibn Saba personally. And so Ibn Saba continued to spread his deviant ideas amongst the Muslims. When Ali was killed, Ibn Saba actually declared that Ali had not been killed. He could not die. Rather, Shaytan had come and taken his form and figure, and Shaytan had died. Ali, he said, could not die because Ali was God incarnate. And he said that Ali radiallahu anhu would eventually come back to this earth. And this belief was known as the belief of the Raj'ah, meaning the return. Raj'ah means to return. They believed that the figure of Ali radiallahu anhu will come back at the end of time. And this belief of a Raj'ah filtered down to all of, or almost all of the Shia groups. So, almost all of the Shia groups believe in the return of some figure. As for the followers of Abdullah ibn Saba, they are called the Saba'iyya. They believe that Ali himself will return, and so they presume that Ali is the Mahdi. The actual Saba'iyya do not exist anymore in our times. However, they were the basis upon which all of the other future Shia and Rafida groups occurred. The most famous of these groups, and the group that is the most associated with the name Shia, is the group known as the Imamiyya, or the Ithna Ashariyya, the 12er branch of Shi'ism. And this branch is the common branch that most Muslims know. They are in Iraq and Iran and Lebanon and other places. This is the common branch and the most popular branch of Shia Islam. They are called Imamiyya because they believe that the Prophet ﷺ himself specified the Imam after him should be Ali and his descendants. And they are called Twelver because they believe in the existence of 12 Imams. These Imams, according to the Shia, have supernatural powers, so much so that they claim that the entire creation is under their control, and that they are all knowledgeable and all powerful. And the Shia also direct many acts of worship to these Imams. If you look at the graves of these Imams and what the Shias do, and even without them, they call out Ya Ali Madad and all of these types of du'as and other types of supernatural help that they seek from these beings.
In our books, in the books of Ahlul Bayt, especially from scholars such as Kashi or from scholars such as Nawabakhti, you find in our own books, in our own libraries, in Najaf and Qum, that we narrate the story of a man called Abdullah ibn Saba. This was one of the men who came to Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullah wa salamu alayhi. On one occasion, and when he comes to him, do you know what he says to him? He says, I believe that you are God. I believe that you are God. He was amongst those people who had taken Ali ibn Abi Talib as being not a Khalifa, not an Imam, not a Prophet. No, he had taken him as being God. Ali ibn Abi Talib asked this man to ask for forgiveness. The man said, no way. I believe from the actions that I've seen of you that you must be God. Ali ibn Abi Talib ordered that the man has to be burnt.
يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا 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 بسعي حثيث لأجل البناء لأجل الرقي لأجل النماء بسعي حثيث لأجل البناء لأجل الرقي لأجل النما نلبي لهذا النداء سلام سلام على الأوفياء سلام سلام على الأوفياء يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا
لنحيي الترابط بين الجميع بود وحب وخير نشيد
بقول جميل وخلق رفيع نشيع التواصل بين الجميع. نشيع التواصل بين الجميع يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا.
Of course, it is well known that the Shi'as do not consider the Sahaba in general to be Muslim, especially the famous Sahaba. They consider them to have really left the fold of Islam and to have usurped the rights of Ali ibn Abi Talib. But they are not just content to expel them from the fold of Islam. Rather, their source books, and this I'm quoting directly from their source books, such as Usul al-Kafi of al-Kulayni and al-Masail al-Nasiriyya of al-Sayyid al-Murtada and other source books, they mention that when the Mahdi leaves his cave, when he is basically set forth into this land, he shall resurrect the dead bodies of Abu Bakr and Umar, bring them back to life, and then torture them, and whip them, and crucify their bodies on trees. Look at the hatred that they have for these noble companions of the Prophet ﷺ. In fact, in some of their sources, it mentions that this shall occur more than once, meaning that the Mahdi will resurrect the bodies of these noble companions more than once, torture them to death, resurrect them, torture them, and so on and so forth for Allahu A'lam how many times. And they also believe that this Mahdi shall come forth with the original Qur'an, the Qur'an of Fatima they call it. Now the Shia source books, all of the Shia source books without exception, and this is something I personally have read from their books printed in their countries from their publishers such as Usul al-Kafi and other works, they clearly mention that the Quran that is existent in our times is deficient, and they claim that Abu Bakr and Umar and others of the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they took out many verses of the Quran pertaining to the high status of Ali and the fact that he deserved the Khilafah besides them. And these narrations are present, as I said, in all of their source books. And in fact, they even have books, entire books written. At-Tabarsi, for example, is one of their authors. He wrote an entire book, which I have as well. All it seeks to do is to prove that the Quran has not been preserved. And the title of the book is The Proofs and the Evidences that the Kalam of the Rabb has not been preserved. This is that the speech of Allah has not been preserved. And so, what is the Kutub al-Mahdi? They believe that Fatima radiallahu anha wrote a special private copy of the Quran that is three times larger than the present Quran and which contains many verses about the wilaya of Ali and the coming of the Imams and so forth. So they believe that this Quran is with the Mahdi, and when he comes, he shall bring this hidden Quran with.